The Absolute's voice is gone, but I still hear its echoes. Reflections of reflections. She's gone. Hells. My own family was never so true. She deserved a better fate than death. Dearest Floric, may your journey to the Fugue Plain be a peaceful one. The Absolute's voice is gone, but
This crown seems too powerful and too dangerous even for Mistra. But I would sooner trust it with a god than a man.
Thank you. Desire.
At least things have stayed interesting.
Go ahead. I'm listening. I question the wisdom of that decision, but so be it. I'll be here in the meantime, idling away the hours.
So, I can't say I would have made the same call, but each their own.
Lead on.
No one back home will ever believe this.
Well, hello.
Someone's been rifling through the wrong pockets. You sense now would be a good time to clarify if that someone is you.
Talked your way out of this one, but there will be no repeat performance.
The path to answer needs a true hero spark. Would they accept a morally questionable hero spark?
Yes. Oh, darling, I'm hurt. It sounds awful.
Let's talk. It's not just a legend. It's a history. Consider this. To Wyrmwë 'neath prison's deepest level. That must mean Wyrm's rock prison. That's where we'll find the entrance to this Wyrmwë. Then this. With the shock of a true hero's spark flickers, the torches alight, and Wyrm's eyes shall awake a glitter. To open the way, we'll need to spark torches. This dragon Onsor was Baldurin's ally. We'd be fools to let him sleep while the dead three's chosen raised the city.
That's the spirit.
Sharp as ever. Give up now.
Let's talk. Are you sure? The blade and just...
What's on your mind? With...
Which way to the nearest library?
Baldurin and his winged ally admiring the fruits of their labor. The city itself.
The statue before you bears a familiar likeness. It is Baldurin, the celebrated adventurer who founded the city of Baldur's Gate.
Peril floods my province. The palisades fall, the earth does tremble. The servants of shadow and blood assemble. Beyond lies the Grand Worm, deep in slumber, awaiting a true hero's advent, should my domain drown in torment. Be you the deluge, turn away. Be you the hero, answer true. Are you worthy?
Poetic nonsense. There is no worm and no savior.
Ancient Ansor, hear me. A champion is proclaimed. The test begins. Let your judgment follow. Face my tests. Prove your worth. A champion burns bright. Even when rushing waters and moaning winds threaten to extinguish the flames, take the torch. Withstand the elements. Prove your courage.
Feet.
Let's finish this.
a beacon to meek and mighty alike. Men ever withstand the raging elements. Proceed.
Board. Why, this might just be the highlight of our misadventure to date.
Ah, excellent choice.
On my mind and, well, in it.
Thank you. Come on, Carmack. Show me who you are.
Roll in my favor. With ease.
feel my mistress's wrath.
Blood comes easy these days. Can't slow down.
Heading out.
Incredible. How old is this place?
Ah! Lanceboard! Why, this might just be the highlight of our misadventures to date.
I thought this place was just a leg.
Thank you.
I applaud your taste.
Paintings hung on the wall. Almost like an art gallery.
A true champion knows justice and eliminates those who stand in its way. Restore the balance of justice.
The child, a red-haired man, is portrayed with his cloak's hood lowered, giving an apple to a smiling urchin. Several other children are huddled behind the one receiving the apple, hands outstretched. The induction. A red-haired man is depicted in hushed conversation with a dark-haired woman. She wears a cloak with an unusual symbol on it, tally marks totaling the number 9. The theft. A red-haired man is depicted in the Hall of Wonders, thieving what looks to be a priceless artifact. It's an astrolabe of entrapment. It could hold a dozen djinn within it, perhaps even more. The chase. A red-haired man is depicted running through the city streets, a flaming fist officer chasing just behind. A cloaked woman, hair dark as a raven, looks on from a safe distance. The judgment. A stern judge, his pockets full of coin, orders a red-haired man to the gallows. A shiny apple rests on the ground nearby.
Away! Behold, the paintings tell the tale. My judgment is rendered. The thief earns his due.
Oh, I could go for a good meal.
Still alive, so that's progress. Shadows are blocking me. I need to get rid of them somehow.
Chase. A red-haired man is depicted running through the city streets, a flaming fist officer chasing just behind. A cloaked woman, hair dark as a raven, looks on from a safe distance. The apple. The painting depicts a red-haired man stealing a shiny apple from a cart in an open-air market. You know this market, the Wide, where Baldur's Gate citizens and visitors gather to conduct trade and wax political. The child. A red-haired man is portrayed with his cloak's hood lowered, giving an apple to a smiling urchin. Several other children are huddled behind the one receiving the apple, hands outstretched.
Lost in thought.
Let's move.
The cell. A stern prison guard slides a warm meal into the thief's cell. The red-haired man has a 10-day left to serve, judging by the scratchings on the wall behind him. Freedom. A red-haired man walks the streets of Baldur's Gate, clad in a billowing cloak. You catch a glimpse of a sly smile beneath his hood. And a golden coin in his hand. The hanging. A red-haired man is depicted hanging from a gallows as a crowd looks on. You notice a child in the crowd, a falling tear leaving a trail on his cheek.
Justice. Proceed.
Hold still, will you?
What's on your mind?
Hold still, will you? Hold still, will you? Hold still, will you?
ignorance.
You have chosen poor counsel.
Unacceptable.
A champion burns bright, even when rushing waters and moaning winds threaten to extinguish the flames. Take the torch. Withstand the elements. Prove your courage.
Let me recite their demise.